Into channels on that Destruction Warlock, the Arms Warrior, Smexin, Chun-Li on the Windwalker Monk, and Gorecki on the Mistweaver Monk. I think she'll be able to deal with channels quite nicely.
This is the first time we're going to see this Windwalker Arms Warrior composition in a tournament setting. Will it be powerful enough to pierce through the armor of Chanimal's Warlock? Super Frogs, I was actually expecting a Mage Warlock from them. We saw them get great success with it last week, and since the Bonded Souls changes, I would only assume that it got even more powerful, but instead going for the Rogue Warlock, Restoration Druid, another composition which they have practiced, and Snuts likely running the Fan of Knives build, focusing on area of effect damage. That way, when the opposing team tries to run away from Chanimal, then Snuts can maximize his pressure. Chanimal has been taking quite a beating here against the pillar, knocked it into line of sight. Smexin opting to retreat away, waiting for Gorecki to be free, but he's very far away, actually engaging a crowd control chain, trying to set up potentially for a kill onto Chanimal, but with very lackluster damage there, is not going to find even a cooldown.
Yeah, Chun-Li is opting to run the Tiger Eye Brew talent, and that's something he's going to be able to build up, stacking buff throughout the game, and when he decides to use it, he turns his damage into not physical damage, but magic damage, and that pierces through a lot of the armor that Chanimal does have available. So once Chun-Li has that up and they decide to pull the trigger with that, Chanimals could definitely be in some trouble, and we've seen Windwalker Monks opt into that talent, specifically against Destruction Warlocks, as it really increases their damage.
I think it's maybe the first time in turn set we've seen Gorecki spreading out onto a Mistweaver Monk. We've seen a lot of his Restoration Druid, but now if he's able to diversify even further, it definitely adds a lot to their roster. I'm curious to see how this matchup plays. So far, I would not say that the boys have found too much pressure overall against the Super Frogs. It's been quite evenly matched so far. I'm curious to see how well they can deny Cubsy from looking for drinks. It's definitely going to be even more significant since the focused growth changes to Restoration Druid, making their Life Bloom much more expensive of a heal. I would like to see the boys switch targets more often. So with currently Ironbark active on Chanimal, a better target to attack during this time would be Snuts, and they are switching some attention to him. This way, Cubsy has to spread his healing onto two targets, but in the meantime, Snuts counter-aggressing with a Shadow Step kick. Good initiation. Chun-Li low on health. Chanimal looking to fake cast, trying to find a Chaos Bolt. Not able to find it just yet, but Snuts is overextended. Caught in a leg sweep. Chanimal backs him up with a triple Shadow Fury. Good backup. Rain of Fire cleaving the entire team. Gorecki appears to be struggling.
Yeah, definitely struggling. You do not want to be grouping up behind the pillar against Snuts with that Fan of Knives specialization. You can see how taxed Gorecki's mana has already been. He needs to play catch-up at this point in the game. Smexin's still low, Gorecki's still low. What is Nuts going to do? Looks like he's going to try to back up Chanimals just a little bit. And in this situation, Cubs deactivating the Thorns. And so far, the boys have been doing a good job of slowing down some of the drinks. Another setup here onto Smexin, as looks like he's going to be able to survive with that Life Cocoon coming in from Gorecki. But this composition isn't working out that great for the boys. I feel like the boys would be playing it a little bit safer if they just sat back and kind of waited a little bit later into dampening. That is where they could sort of push through some of the defensives that Chanimal has available. But these exchanges don't seem to be going in their favor.
I think ultimately Snuts is going to be the target that goes down if a target goes down for the Super Frogs. Chanimal's Destruction Warlock, they can't seem to dent him. Currently a setup onto Smexin with multiple Chaos Bolts. Chanimal fake casts the spell Reflect. He's not going to be eating his own Chaos Bolt anytime soon. Definitely a difficult task to get through multiple interrupts. Now with all three members of the boys pushing forward, they are looking for a big push onto Chanimal. He deflects it with a double Mortal Coil, but Cubsy's still locked out in some crowd control, opts to trinket out. Now trying to swap to Gorecki, catching one Chaos Bolt, perhaps a second. With Way of the Crane, he should stabilize. Smexin leading the charge here for the boys. Pressure onto two targets. Perfect situation for the boys. This two-pronged assault is definitely going to run Cubsy for a loop.
Yeah, Chanimal's still low. He's in some trouble. Smexin and Chun-Li all over him. Snuts trying to counter pressure. Kidney shot now secured onto Chun-Li. If he can survive, he still has a touch of karma to turn this pressure in their favor if he really needs to. But he's being a little bit greedy right now with the leg sweep on his Snuts. He's feeling relatively safe. Gorecki still, he has a lot of work to do here, Sid. He needs to keep Chun-Li and Smexin healthy so they continue this push. But with Chanimals topped off, things aren't looking good for the boys.
Yeah, with Chun-Li and Smexin attacking into Thorns, they're taking huge damage. Snuts is then going to go after the healer Gorecki to add even more pressure points onto the side of the boys. That's costing Gorecki even more mana. We haven't even made it to dampening, and Gorecki is almost tapped. And I would say it's unlikely that he will find opportunities to drink on the Grand Arena when facing this composition. There are just so many ways to deny it. Gorecki charges to center field. Looks like he wants to start something here while Cubsy was sitting down for a drink. They deny the drink. They get evasion. This is a good push from the boys. Now they should switch their attention to Chanimal. Try and create pressure on another point. Burn Cubsy's mana down even further. Smoke bomb bomb gets dropped by Snuts as he's trying to make something happen here onto Smexen, but really not finding too much off the back of it. Cubsy once again sneaking away to drink while there's pressure on Smexen. Chun-Li able to move over and deny that. Greki is going to get trained down by Snuts, and Chanimal is going to 1v2 Chun-Li and Smexen, it looks like, for the rest of the fight. And I think that's a great situation for the Super Frogs. They've got pressure in so many different locations. Chanimal finally starts to take a bit of a beating. Cubsy denies the kill with Iron Bark for now. Snuts moves back to support, but he walks into a trap. Double leg sweep for Chun-Li and huge damage to follow it up.
Yeah, Snuts getting bursted down. Cubsy's going to have to top off Snuts here. Greki and Cubsy relatively even on mana. Chun-Li been doing a great job in this game so far, using his Ring of Peace from range to slow down Cubsy whenever he goes for these stealth drinks. He's been really doing a great job keeping an eye on him, not allowing him to reset his mana, and I think that's very important for the boys, as it doesn't seem like Gorecki's going to ever have that same opportunity.
This wave of the crane push for Gorecki needs to pay off. They need to get an unending resolve with this, and they do. Chanimal's just going to respect the damage and try and counter-aggress during this moment of time, but that was one major objective that the boys have finally managed to break off from the Super Frogs. Mana is tied at this point as we step foot into dampening. It's still anyone's match. Currently, momentum in favor of the Super Frogs. Smexen has to abort the mission, leaping back to Gorecki, but now he's stacked up with Snuts. Snuts can have at two targets. Chanimal can have free reign on Chun-Li in midfield with Thorns. Huge redirected damage. Greki's got no mana left. It's unlikely that we see another wave of the Crane. The threat of him activating more damage is basically lost, and the boys are starting to struggle.
Yeah, Tiger Eye Brew gets activated by Chun-Li. He's trying to get aggressive onto Chanimals. Huge burst damage coming in. Cubsy tries to redirect it with the Iron Bark, but Chanimal's getting low. Almost in execute range. That is not a place you want to be against an Arms Warrior, especially Smexen, as they're ripping into him. Cubsy completely tapped on mana at this point. Greki activating the last little defensive cooldown that he has left. He doesn't have mana for Wave of the Crane. Not going to be able to rely on that to catch back up his team. And it looks like with Super Frog stabilized, the boys are in a lot of trouble.
Thorns is available for Cubsy. He needs to activate that as soon as possible. But Smexen leaps over, denies the drink, and secures crowd control for the team. They make a swap onto Snuts. I'm not the biggest fan of this, as Snuts still has evasion to make a trade. Chanimal lays down a gateway if he needs an escape. Smexen is still getting pressured. Greki really struggling to heal through the damage output from the Super Frogs currently here. Touch of Death gets activated. Chun-Li needs to make something happen with this Touch of Death. They find a bit of pressure, but nowhere near a kill. Three members low on the team of the boys. Dampening gets higher and higher. Cubsy moves across the map. He's looking to secure crowd control and potentially close this game out. Chanimals finds a Chaos Bolt, gets pummeled. Good denial by Smexen. They're slowing down the pressure, but inevitably this Chaos Bolt is going to be connecting, and as soon as it does, it could easily be the end of the game. Double Mortal Coil. Blind attempt. Greki breaks that right away, but Smexen's still low. Life Cocoon saves him. They catch Snuts with a double stun lock. Cubsy comes out just in the nick of time. Smexen is still low. One Chaos Bolt. Life Cocoon denies the kill on Smexen. Ring of Peace prevents Snuts from getting back to his target. Cubsy tries to add in a Maledict here on the Smexen, just getting out a couple of Wraths, trying to add in as much damage as he can. It's a race to the finish. Both teams completely tapped, and Snuts is likely to fall first. He shadow steps out, back behind Cubsy, and Chanimal takes the kill. Snuts is still low on health, caught into a leg sweep, and he's likely to go down here. If they can get any damage, Chanimal MVP play, keeping Snuts alive. No, Chun-Li finds the kill. And now in this 2v2, who really comes out ahead, man?
I really don't know. Chanimal's on the Destruction Warlock is going to be very strong in this matchup with Cubsy, Chun-Li, and Gorecki. I know they practice 2v2 a lot as well. These teams are very experienced in these matchups. We're at 22% dampening. Both these healers are If Cubsy can sneak away and get a drink here, it's going to be really good for their team.
He might rez.
Maybe. I feel like it's really unlikely that actually happens against these players, but if he goes for it, potentially he could. If Chanimals can find the crowd control in the match, it's definitely a possibility. But I think Chun-Li, with the talents he's playing, is actually going to be doing quite well in this matchup with the Tiger Eye Brew. As long as he can build it up, his pressure onto Chanimals will be immense.
All right, at this point, dampening ramping up. Cubsy with a slight mana lead. I'm really looking to see if Chun-Li uses his Touch of Karma aggressively to redirect Thorn's damage. Currently, crowd control initiation by the boys. This is going to start putting them significantly ahead. Super Frogs need to be careful and not disrespect this push, as Chun-Li has activated Touch of Death. That's going to explode. Bursting Chanimal. Cubsy doesn't have very much mana to heal through that damage. Greki looks like he may be trying to sneak away. No, opting to actually just roll across the map. They have to deny the drink. Ring of Peace snipes Cubsy, putting him back in combat. Ring of Peace again to just annoy Cubsy more or less. Chun-Li, it's basically Chun-Li versus Chanimal, as both healers are tapped on mana. Who can output more damage or get a clean setup? I think the instant crowd control definitely goes in favor of the boys, but you can never count a Chaos Bolt out.
Yeah, that's true. At any moment, Chanimals could take someone out potentially, but I feel like with Chun-Li, with the talents he's playing, they've got to be favored in this matchup. Gorecki's playing the counteract magic as well, so that's going to be counteracting a lot of the immolate damage Shanimal does have available. But as dampening gets higher and higher, that instant healing doesn't really matter nearly as much. Pubsy with Innervate, trying to keep Chanimals nice and healthy. And for Gorecki, it's really unlikely. You can see him on the left side of your screen. He has a little Fell Hunter on him that's going to be preventing him from dropping combat and ever really going for a drink in this matchup. So for the boys, they need to just make sure Cubsy's not regenerating mana, but it's not looking good. I mean, Cubsy has been able to hold on to a lot of this mana. Chun-Li now making a swap onto Cubsy. Now, with the Tiger Eye Brute talent, Cubsy in bear form is going to be a vulnerable target as well. So as long as Chun-Li can use that ability, have uptime on a target, I feel like his damage will be able to push through some of these defensives that Super Frogs has available.
Cubsy's just running across the map and trying to sit down to get a drink. This will either regenerate him mana or pull the opposing team out into midfield, and that's the main objective for Chanimal, is to get a target out in the open. Currently, it's a bit of a race here to kill Cubsy or to kill Chun-Li. Who will fall first? Multiple Chaos Bolts flying in. Touch of Karma rearranges that damage back onto Cubsy. Multiple trades have to be made. It's desperation mode here at almost 40% dampening. Cubsy almost completely tapped, but now he's got thorns in his back pocket. He could trade that out and redirect some damage to Chun-Li. I'm waiting to see. He's going to activate that thorns on the Touch of Death. Perfect timing. Chun-Li has to make a decision. Does he attack into thorns, boost his damage with Touch of Death, but also have some of it redirected, or does he just abort the kill? And it looks like he's going to abort the opportunity to try and get a kill, then come back after thorns. Cubsy gets caught out of bear form. Bit of a mistake here on Cubsy's part. He's disrespecting the damage, not using that Glider's Medallion. Tries to jump to safety, gets Ring of Peace back into Chun-Li. Chanimal deflects Chun-Li with a Mortal Coil, now with a Bash. And that Mortal Coil and a Bash is definitely a kill chain of crowd control that the Super Frogs can utilize to take down the boys here in game number one. Chun-Li looks like he's just going to be training Cubsy for the rest of the match.
Yeah, I think it's an intelligent decision as well. Destruction Warlocks are just so hard to take care of. But the thing is, with Chanimal's free casting in this matchup, there's going to be a lot of pressure here for the Super Frogs. And in that last exchange, they were able to get Life Cocoon as well as a Touch of Karma from Chun-Li. And Chun-Li now super vulnerable. No Diffuse Magic, no Touch of Karma, no nothing for another 20 seconds. So he's going to have to be careful, can no longer afford to just sit on Cubsy. He has to wait for some of those cooldowns to come back up, rotate available to him, so he can once again make an offensive push on Cubsy if he really wants to.
All right, Cubsy sits down for a drink. Chanimal passes him a gateway if some Chun-Li wants to go after him. Chun-Li is really not taking the better end of this exchange. Currently in midfield, trying to race Chanimal now at almost 50% dampening. That's almost 50% healing reduction in the match. Both monks going for a double stun lock. This is a good setup by the boys. Ironbark exchanges. I love the Ring of Peace volleyballs. I want to see more of that. I actually think it's a great lockdown that does not share diminishing return with stuns. Could be a way to pinch Chanimal down and prevent Chaos Bolt long enough to take him out. Cubsy once again just doing the long kiting path across the midfield, trying to bait Gorecki and Chun-Li out into center field so that Chanimal can free cast. Gorecki is reluctantly trying not to expose himself. Cubsy is just sneaking away. Maybe he goes for a res. Curious to see if he decides to go for a res or drink. Drink is obviously safer with Chun-Li feared. Gorecki out of position. Cubsy may get some mana. Nope, not able to at all. Innervate available. Both healers still tapped now at 50% dampening. Chanimal connecting a Chaos Bolt off the back end of a fear. Good combo by Chanimal, building pressure for himself. Life Cocoon has to be exchanged. Momentum now swinging in favor of the Super Frogs.
Yeah, things are looking good for the Super Frogs here. Chun-Li at some point needs to make an offensive push. He has every single cooldown available to him. And I'm just curious to see, does he go after Cubsy? Does he go after Chanimal? Chanimal still has a good response with the unending resolve, but it's going to become more and more difficult for Cubsy to actually keep him alive. And it looks like Chun-Li, he wants to get aggressive on Cubsy. Gets caught into a paralysis. Touch of Death gets used. Cubsy immediately trinkets gateways away, but still, Chun-Li all over him. Touch of Death will proc, but Chun-Li doesn't want to mess around for too long, allowing Chanimals to free cast. Goes over there, gets interrupted, and as long as Cubsy sits in the open, Chun-Li's going to have a difficult time sitting here and really getting pressure out onto Cubsy, as Chanimal's basically acting like a turret for his team, pressuring both Chun-Li and Gorecki away.
Oh, spell lock on Gorecki. Chun-Li is low on health and out of range. Actually just decides to go back into midfield. This is a bit of a risk. Nice fake cast by Chanimal. He expected Chun-Li to use Touch of Karma on that Chaos Bolt, so Chanimal stopped his Chaos Bolt right before it finished.
Oh.
Now Touch of Karma is used and no exchange of damage. Cubsy was able to potentially regenerate some mana amidst all of this. Infernals are available. Super Frogs have a massive lead. All they have to do is push forward and power through. Infernals have landed. Thorns are up. Tons of damage redirected towards Chun-Li. He has to give up on that kill attempt. This now is going to make it awkward for Chanimal. What does he do? Does he run in there and try and push them over, or does he just stay in midfield and regenerate mana? Potentially going for a res could be a good way to force Chun-Li and Gorecki off the pillar, but effectively getting not too much done with his Infernals. I mean, at least a full mana bar on Cubsy, but if he can't find a kill, Chun-Li can just go in and out so easily, dodge these Chaos Bolts. Actually just taking one for free. Now deciding to retreat back to the pillar. Dark Soul still available, and I mean, with Dampening at 62%, even Immolate is eventually going to kill someone.
Yep, that Counteract Magic becoming less and less effective in this matchup. I actually don't mind Chanimals the way he used the Infernals. He was under a lot of pressure, dropped the Infernals to basically force Chun-Li to run away. Didn't have to trade out the Unending Resolve or the Dark Soul just yet. Cubsy looking for a res, immediately gets shut down on that. Now Chun-Li wants to get aggressive in this matchup, but he's still not topped off and really doesn't have any defensive cooldowns. That Thorns from Cubsy will do work, but Cubsy's really going to struggle keeping Chanimals healthy in this matchup. Greki's still just sitting back, doesn't have the Life Cocoon. And basically, Chun-Li, he needs to avoid every single Chaos Bolt, because once that lands, it is so difficult for Greki to re-recover that HP, and Chun-Li's self-healing isn't going to be nearly as effective. Cubsy looking for a res once again, gets shut down, but that forces Chun-Li and Greki's hand. They have to charge in. They can't just hide behind the pillar and get a free reset. So I love that Cubsy is threatening that from the boys.
Chanimal and Chun-Li going at each other here, trading powerful defensives to just stay in the fight, but Chanimal is eking a little bit ahead here at almost 70%. Dampening. Ursula's Vortex to hold Chun-Li in the open. Greki moves in with Way of the Crane. They have to get a kill, but he gets thwarted. Mortal Coil, potentially a fear, a full fear. Greki trinkets. They have a bash. They have a bash. If Chanimal gets a Chaos Bolt on this, Greki could easily go down. He gets it. Greki barely stays alive. He's desperately trying to add some counter pressure, but now he's just exposed in midfield. He has to portal out. They stun Chun-Li.
Oh, no!
Portal was in the wrong place at the wrong time. Very fortunate for him to be able to even get back to the pillar in that position. Almost a throw for the boys, but at 71% dampening, their health is not going to go up. Cubsy is putting pressure by casting Revive. Even if he doesn't get it, Chanimal can sneak in a couple damage spells while he's going for it. So either Cubsy will get a Revive or Chanimal will kill them. They've got them in checkmate.
Yep, Greki's still low. No mana available. How is he going to recover? Chun-Li almost has the Touch of Karma. Activates the Diffuse Magic. He's looking to take Chanimals down. Cubsy almost has that Iron Bark. Chanimal's still very vulnerable. It's 73% dampening. It is do or die for Chun-Li and the boys. Like you said, they cannot afford to just run and reset consistently in this matchup, but they really have no choice. They stay out in the open. They'll die if they hide behind the pillar. They're going to die. Cubsy looking for a res. If Snuts is alive, they're going to die. So there's a lot that the boys have to consider in this matchup, but this is looking really good for the Super Frogs.
Oh, Mortal Coil, Bash, double Chaos Bolt. No way you're making it out alive. The Super Frogs secure game one.
Oh, my goodness. I mean, the Super Frogs want to play this comp. We already saw it work for them. The boys, this is the composition that they wanted to play into this comp with. The boys and the Super Frogs both have their plans in order. It all comes down to who the more skilled team is, tied for first place in North America. Super Frogs looking to get themselves on match point. The boys trying to tie this one up.
Yeah, and what's interesting about this composition is you would think it would be the ultimate Warlock killer, but Chanimal still managing to survive, and most of the pressure we saw in the last game was the boys going after Snuts and these double stuns. Snuts isn't going to have as many heal over time effects when he gets caught into those stuns as Chanimals is the primary target, so it's a great opportunity for the boys to get some pressure rolling, and I think potentially we see Snuts be the main focus in this game once again.
Yeah, I think definitely before dampening, switching to the Rogue is a great opportunity. You attack the Warlock, Cubsy gets his life blooms comfortably on the Warlock, and then when you get crowd control such as this intimidating shout from Smexen, you can switch targets to the Rogue, who doesn't have that life bloom, get a ton of burst out, and then force Cubsy to expend mana when he comes out of the crowd control to switch the life blooms to that target. And I think that strategy is definitely what the boys should employ before dampening, maybe after dampening has engaged for some time, the Warlock just becomes the better target overall, but prior to that, they are trying to catch Snuts in center field as all three members of the boys collide. Snuts doesn't take too much damage from that attack as he's able to completely stabilize. I love what Cubsy is doing, just adding in Solar Wraths, adding in just a tiny bit of extra damage. I mean, look at this, just the tiniest bit of extra damage from Cubsy might just put Smexen over the edge.
Yeah, Smexen almost going down there. Like you said, Cubsy, I think he casted 10 Solar Wraths in a row, and that damage definitely does add up if you have the free time. Cubsy now getting swapped too. Has to be a little careful activating the Barf Skin, but no major loss there for the Super Frogs as Snuts move in. And like we kind of talked about, this is not the best position here for the boys. If they're all grouped up behind the pillar, that's when Snuts is going to be able to do work. And they realize that, so they're moving forward. They don't want to be caught behind the pillar. Once again, trying to get some damage rolling onto Chanimals, but he's just so durable on the Destruction Warlock.
Ooh, Snuts is trying to dodge a leg sweep. If he stacks up on Chanimal, they've been doing these Stormbolt Cubsy, leg sweep Snuts and Chanimal. So Snuts is, he's going in and out. You see, as a rogue, he'd normally want to be right next to his target attacking, but he's trying to avoid getting stunned. But now he's overextended behind the pillar. Greki catches him. Chun-Li's trying to pull back to assist with some pressure, but Snuts is able to escape. Good backup by Chanimal. You can just tell that Chanimal's completely aware of his entire team with his fear timings, making sure that any point one of his teammates is stunned, he's getting out as many fears as he can to stall the damage out so that his friend can escape. Smexen getting pinned down and taking quite a beating here. I would say that Super Frogs are establishing a lead.
Yeah, I think that is definitely fair to say. Some talent adaptations I've noticed from these teams. In the meantime, one Cubsy's getting caught into the stun. Leg Sweep, Storm Bolt will force out basically everything from Cubsy. Trinket, Barkskin, and Iron Bark. So Cubsy's definitely going to be a vulnerable target moving forward. But that was the touch of death committed by Chun-Li. And one thing I noticed from Chun-Li is he's no longer running that Tiger Eye Brew I was kind of talking about. He went over to the Alpha Tiger ability, and that's basically going to give him a mini Bloodlust anytime he does use his Tiger Palm on a target. And I think that is kind of just big damage over on the Specs, but I think that kind of shows that necessarily Chanimals isn't going to be the main focus in this matchup. They don't want that armor-piercing ability. They might go after Cubsy or Snuts in these swaps.
This is what I like from Snuts, is him attacking Gurecki far away from Chanimal, where Chun-Li and Specs are. This way, Snuts can't be swapped to as easily unless Gurecki has Leg Sweep. Chanimal getting bursted here with crowd control on Cubsy. This looks good for the boys here to force some major cooldowns. Maybe get a kill if the Super Frogs don't respond in time. Chanimal trying to recover. Not much defense for 5 more seconds. They need to stall. Chanimal with great stall. Buys time for Cubsy. Now booting him back to full health with that innervate. Some free healing. Well timed there. Mana is fairly even at this point, which is a bit unexpected. The map selection from the boys is definitely peculiar, because on this map, Cubsy can easily escape and find drinks. I'm not a big fan of the selection from the boys overall. I'm wondering if they were thinking about playing a different composition. But definitely a smaller map would have been more favorable. Good cross crowd control initiation from the Super Frogs as they look to close game number 2. Smexen barely stays alive thanks to Gurecki at this moment in time, but their defensive cooldowns have been overlapped and now create a vulnerability moving forward.
Yeah, Smexen, no Die by the Sword available. Like you said, there's not too much for the boys to really work with in the situation, but Snuts gets caught behind the pillar. Gladiator Safeguard keeping him alive. He gets pinned against the wall. Nice ring of peace by Chun-Li. Very scary.
Whoa.
Snuts, but Gurecki getting low. Huge Chaos Bolt by Chanimal.
Chanimal.
Into a Mortal Coil. Can he just solo him? Snuts needs to connect. Finds the Kidney Shot. Gurecki still no Trinket for a few more seconds. Do they have the damage? Shadow Fury. Chaos Bolt lands. Good night, Gurecki. And Super Frogs claim game number 2.
Super Frogs.
Animal be able to 3-0 the boys here in the upper bracket. This could easily be a grand final to start the day off, but they are looking strong on this Warlock, Rogue, Restoration, Druid composition. Super Frogs initiating crowd control, but no attack just yet. I do like Chanimal's positioning down out of line of sight. This way, if they overextend on him on the outside perimeter, the opposing healer Gurecki will then have to run into center field to heal. Definitely positioning is going to be important, but in the meantime, the boys have initiated. Chanimal looks to deny the initial attack by using his Glider's Medallion and dropping an Infernal. This is an attempt to scare Chun-Li and Smexen away. They're boldly staying in front of Chanimal. Chanimal fake casting to Mind Freeze, going for a double Mortal Coil. Definitely been on point with that Warlock. Bit of unfortunate pathing. Chun-Li out of line of sight. Chanimal still looking for fake casts. Now with both interrupts out of the way, he's going to be sneaking into Chaos Bolt. He's dropped multiple Rain of Fire. He's boosted his damage quite heavily with that Supremacy. This next Chaos Bolt will be a gigantic one if he manages to get it.
Chanimal's in a little bit of trouble here, and you have to wonder for the boys why they didn't initially lock in this composition. This is really all they've been running in these tournaments, so maybe they have played out this matchup and not the most confident in it, but I like that they're going back to their comfort pick, as the last two games didn't seem too great, and the Grand Arena was close, the second game, not really. So going back to their comfort pick, Windwalker, Death Knight, Chanimal's now getting low, he's under pressure. Cubsy should be able to heal him up, but he's out of line of sight. Chanimal's gets gripped away, double Mortal Coil will keep him alive and in the fight. Cubsy in a great spot to keep those heals up. Good positioning right now. Cubsy always just staying so far away from Smexen, never really in range to get death gripped or into the paralysis of Chun-Li. And I just think I really like the way Cubsy's playing it. And now he's actually just going for a drink.
I think Chanimal's positioning on the box here is to try and get Gurecki to move in, but he gets Ring of Peace downstairs out of multiple points of line of sight and completely exposed, potentially going to go down in game number 3. Unending Resolve exchanges, keeps him alive a tad bit longer, but Smexen nails an interrupt onto the healer paralysis to follow, and Chanimal gets owned. The boys take game number 3, and the boys are back.
Okay, so my big question here is how much do you...
Been having a great performance on the DK. but his warrior is actually his main, so this guy has definitely been stepping up to the plate for his team. But I do want to say that I'm not a big fan of not having Shanimal in the game. I actually would have rather seen the Mage Lock Druid. I think Snuts might be a little bit exploitable here on the Shadow Priest. I'm not sure how practiced he is on this as they make a setup on him.
Great crowd control by the boys early on, trying desperately to bring this to a game five. If they can manage to, Ashamines is already out of the pool. There's no really large maps available for the Super Frogs to counterpick the boys, but obviously Tolvaron is going to be their most difficult hurdle to get over. But if they can get over it, they still stand a good chance of potentially overthrowing the Super Frogs in a reverse sweep. But with the pressure currently getting dished out by the Frogs, I'm not sure if that's going to be the case. Two targets low on health, multiple defensives exchanged in multiple places. Grecki's going to need to keep his head level to try and heal through this pressure, managing to recover. Snuts now being pushed back. It may be an exchange of Vampiric Embrace. Good trade on Snuts's part, rotating effectively with Cubsy.
Yeah, definitely. We'll have to see which affinities both of these Restoration Druids are using. I think Cubsy's actually going with the Feral affinity, so opting to get a little bit more aggressive in this matchup. Potentially, if Smexen and Chun-Li realize this, they could go after them, but the problem with that is Wealthy Man and Snuts will really be able to punish them if they can't take down Cubsy really quickly. Chun-Li now in center field, Snuts in void form, putting out a ton of pressure. This is the Icy Veins of Wealthy Man as well. Unfortunately, they really weren't able to get too many cooldowns. They got Karecki's Trinket, but outside of that, still the boys are looking really healthy.
Cubsy is not running Master Shapeshifter, though, as playing with a Shadow Priest and a Mage, they're going to be taking heavy fire. He probably can't spend that much time in cat form, so his main goal is to just have the mobility to run on the map and get drinks, and also re-stealth and add stuns to his team, whereas Grecki is running with the Master Shapeshifter, so he gets 25% more damage in cat form, and Grecki with that melee cleave, he definitely needs to get in the face of the opposing team and dish out counter pressure. Crowd control initiated by the boys, but they're still under fire. Two targets dangerously low on health. You can tell that Bonded Soul change definitely affecting the boys' composition this week.
Yeah, definitely. Snuts a little bit low, but he stabilizes. Now a silence on a Grecki with no trinket available. Cubsy throwing in some rats as well. Chun-Li forced to trade out his Touch of Karma. Now more of a vulnerable target in the matchup. And normally we don't see Chun-Li go with the Fortifying Brew, but opting into a little bit more defense in this matchup, he needs those windows of opportunity like I talked about. They have to get through with the Shadow Priest. They have to get through the Fade, the potential Dispersion, as well as that Iron Bark. They really want to start finding win conditions in this game, but Snuts getting bursted down as he gets interrupted. Should be okay. Cubsy's still in a healthy spot. If we look at mana, Grecki still has a little bit of a lead. I'm not sure if he was able to sneak away and get a drink just yet, but that is definitely important for the boys to stay ahead on mana.
Smexen running that Dark Simulacrum. We have to wait and see if he manages to steal any crowd control to add to his team for a big push. Snuts has been maxing out his damage quite effectively. We were kind of questioning whether or not he'd be the weak link, but so far, he's doing so much damage. Chun-Li on the back foot, basically start to finish. Mind control at low health, denying Garecki's Iron Bark. He needs to be careful he doesn't use that on the wrong target, not falling for that trap. Chun-Li now activating Touch of Death, trying to go for the kill. Cubsy and Snuts deny, activating their defense just in time. And now Snuts can look to get aggressive again with that full Insanity bar, the purple bar below his health. When that is full, he can go into Void Form such as this and increase his damage, get access to Void Bolt, a big hard-hitting instant cast ability. And Chun-Li has to respect that Void Form. Transcendence portal back to safety with his healer at the pillar, but they've left Smexen behind, and the Super Frogs will gladly cause damage his way.
Yep, and Snuts actually going for full-on damage in this matchup, going crit, haste, as well as the Auspicious Spirits talent. So it's going to give him a lot of instant cast damage here, but make him vulnerable without that added versatility you would normally see a Shadow Priest pick up, potentially. Now a double Light Sweep on Snuts. He's getting bursted down. I think that's the first Dispersion of the game that Snuts has been forced into. Cubsy's still doing quite well on mana, activates the Innervate to easily top off Snuts, but the boys, they can't afford to be sitting in the open for too long as all three members are potentially rotting down.
I mean, look at this pressure right now out from the Super Frogs. I do believe that Smexen was able to steal something effective there, potentially a Polymorph. He was. He now Polymorphs Cubsy. They switch targets to Wealthy Man. I like this swap. I think it's very important against the Restoration Druids that you switch targets frequently if you want to try and catch a target without Live Plume or expend the Druid's mana. They've been spending a lot of time on Snuts, but anytime they stack up, I would like to see the boys switch, and right now we see them swapping to Snuts again. Swapping around definitely important, but in the meantime, Cubsy has secured crowd control. Snuts is still on the back foot, even with Iron Bark struggling a bit to recover. Cubsy opts to use his Glider's Medallion to break out of Paralysis. You do not normally want to break out of that crowd control with your Medallion. It's the shortest one available for the boys. He'd much rather save that for something longer, like a Bash or a Cyclone or Asphyxiate. So now Cubsy is behind. The boys are showing signs of life here in game four, but Smexen needs to stay in it a bit longer.
Yeah, he definitely does. He's in a lot of trouble. No anti-magic shell available. He grips over Wealthy Man, finds a Death Strike. Gurecki connects the Ironbark, but Smexen not out of it yet. Beautiful crowd control here by Chun-Li, slowing down Snuts, getting some pressure for his team. Wealthy Man turning his attention to Chun-Li now as they look to get some damage rolling with his Psychic Horror onto Chun-Li. He still has a touch of Karma, going to be trading that out onto Wealthy Man. Wealthy Man blinks away out into the open as Smexen and Chun-Li look to chase. Incapacitate onto Cubsy into a stun. This could be the first ice block of Wealthy Man, but good kiting, good mind controls coming in from Snuts as well onto Chun-Li, really slowing down the boys and giving Cubsy some time to recover.
You see a silence on Gurecki, Chun-Li being pressured, Smexen low as well as we move into dampening. The damage isn't going to stop. Wealthy Man has been left open most of this game, maxing out his damage, and that is eventually going to be deadly. Smexen dips low. Now Snuts being counter-pressured, trying to drag them out in the open so Wealthy Man can potentially polymorph Gurecki, but not able to find it. Instead, we see Asphyxiate initiated by Smexen, really trying to lead the charge. Dark Simulacrom, what did Smexen manage to snag? We'll find out shortly. Snuts has to disperse. That's a cooldown overlap. The Super Frogs are starting to falter in terms of cooldown. They have a lead on in regards to mana, and it's likely that they will be able to hold that with the composition in the map that they have selected. But they're not denying Gurecki's drink right now. Snuts moves into position, but he was able to deny at least some mana regeneration. Cubsy gets a significant lead in that regard. Cooldown's forced now from Smexen, but Snuts is still low. Caught in a stun, he can't void shift, and the boys are looking to move to game five. They do it just in the nick of time. They overcome the most difficult map and difficult strategy the Super Frogs had.
Game five, going to be the decider. Whoever wins this gets to stay in the upper bracket. Both of these teams in the dead tie for the year, and that advantage could be huge.
Beautiful blink by Wealthy Man, dodging that double leg sweep. Wealthy Man was baiting Chun-Li to charge right in by standing on Snuts. Blinked 1 second before Chun-Li went for a stun and avoided it. That was some clutch play, a bit of a risky decision, but obviously the Super Frogs are alive and ready here for the game five. They believe in this composition. We are surprised to not see Chanimal come back in on that Destruction Warlock, but I guess they're going to chalk it up to mistakes were made. The boys, though, going after Wealthy Man, and on this smaller map, Tiger's Peak, switching targets is a lot easier. He gets bursted down. It's game five. He can't afford not to trade. Ice Block gets forced, overlapped with the Iron Bark, and the boys are bringing the
I'm going to be honest with you. I think the main X factor in this game has been Gurecki on the Resto Druid. His ability to balance his Feral Affinity with offense and defense, push in, get the damage rolling when his team needs it, that's what we were missing from the boys in game number one and game number two. When Gurecki's on his Resto Druid, the boys make me a believer.
Yep, they definitely do. I'm glad to see Gurecki back on that Feral Affinity, even though I think diversifying into that Mistweaver in the future would be crucial for their team overall. Right now, his Feral Affinity Restoration Druid is easily unparalleled with Druid play in the current build. Wealthy Man getting swapped too. I do like the boys switching their targeting up, really throwing Cubsy for a loop in terms of where he needs to dedicate the most amount of healing, although leaving Snuts open to develop momentum with these C2 members starting to rot down on the side of the boys. Gurecki just having a field day with his Feral Affinity, sneaking away, jumping into stealth, stunning up a target, and adding a lot of extra pressure for his team.
Yeah, definitely Gurecki looking for a Cyclone onto Snuts. He ended up fading it, so potentially they could swap over to Snuts now without that fade available. Nice grip into double leg sweep. Wealthy Man could be in some trouble. Potentially the second ice block coming in is looking to kite away. Snuts trying to counter pressure here into the void form, getting a lot of damage rolling onto all three members of the boys. Gurecki's going to have to play catch up here. He gets caught into a bash, activates the bark skin, and I really like Super Frogs punishing Gurecki a little bit more. When he's playing this aggressive with the Feral Affinity, I want to see them making swaps to him, put out pressure, making sure he has to really second guess himself.
Uh-oh.
He's going to be moving in.
Gurecki gets bursted down, and as that Feral Affinity are a lot more fragile, so he definitely needs to be careful when he's navigating around the map. If the Super Frogs switch their attention to him, he could be a vulnerability for the team. His mana isn't looking too good, and that's because the boys are splitting their pressure and adding damage to multiple targets. It's really becoming difficult for Cubsy to dish out the healing he needs. Now he may need to look and try and sneak away for a drink to regenerate that mana, because Gurecki is starting to get a bit of a lead in that regard. And as the Wizard Cleave healer, you definitely don't want to fall behind in mana. That is your main win condition. You see Gurecki jumping into the fight. Triple crowd control initiated by the boys. Can Gurecki maybe get a clone? He's going to add some extra damage with a big ferocious bite. Wealthy Man gets life grip back to midfield. They desperately try to reconnect to force the ice block. They grip Wealthy Man out of line of sight. Drops that frozen orb to try and kite, but even that might not be enough. Is it going to be good night. Garecki pushes forward, adding a bit of extra damage. They're trying to go all out for this second Ice Bucket, but they're not finding it. Garecki spends too much time in midfield. Snuts is pressuring him away. He can't stay on target, and they don't get the block.
Yet, Chun-Li still has his touch of death. This is a great moment in the match to actually go after, and you can notice Wealthy Man's not playing Temporal Shield, so that the only thing they really have to get through is that Iron Bark in this matchup. Garecki getting swapped too as they continue the pressure onto Wealthy Man. Chun-Li still sitting on his touch of death. I have to wonder why he's not using it. I really feel like that would be the added damage they need to push through some of the defenses Wealthy Man has available and potentially get that ice block and make a swap over onto Snuts. Garecki finding the re-stealth. Asphyxiate onto Cubsy. Snuts a little bit of a vulnerable target here, but still doing fine. I think Cubsy or Garecki was actually able to sneak away, regenerate his mana with that drink, and that is keeping the boys in this fight.
Snuts getting bursted down. He lands a double psychic scream onto both Smexen and Chun-Li to stall the fight out just a tad bit longer. Now looking to counter-aggress with tons of damage on that frozen orb. Wealthy Man trying to get some space, chuck out a couple of frost bolts. Garecki re-hotting the team and likely to look for a re-stealth afterwards, trying to add some extra stuns to the team. Dispelling off those dots, jumping in for a big ferocious bite potentially here, and he gets punished though, jumping into the fight. Wealthy Man immediately switches to him. This is exactly what the Super Frogs needed to do. Garecki responds, but he responds a little bit late. The damage isn't stopping. Just a tiny bit more to take down Garecki. Chun-Li trying to support in the back line. Maybe some vivifies, any extra healing possible to allow Garecki to stabilize. Garecki's gonna have to play a lot more safe. If he gets caught like that again, it's gonna be curtains.
Well, this is match point as well. There's a lot on the line for both of these teams. Cubsy gets caught into the bash. He gets the Iron Bark onto Snuts preemptively. Snuts trying to kite away with the fade, manages to escape. Wealthy Man looking for some polymorphs, really just trying to play defense for his team right now. Another polymorph secured onto Cubsy. That was stolen by Smexen, so Wealthy Man and Cubsy, they have to be very careful that Smexen isn't getting these very important spells with his Dark Simulacrum, because that's going to allow the boys to get the added crowd control they need to take someone down. Snuts, once again, he trades out his trinket preemptively before the Void Shift, and that's one of the reasons why they fell in the last game. Snuts had the Void Shift, but he didn't have the trinket available to get out of the leg sweep. And I really want to see Snuts be patient with that, as that is such a key part of their defense.
Yeah, most certainly is. Wealthy Man getting pressured here. If they can get this block, maybe they can kill him on Hypothermia pushing forward. Garecki still has the mana lead. This is not looking good for the Super Frogs. The series is slipping away from their grasp. They had a significant lead, but now they're falling behind as the boys switch to their main composition, that bread and butter. Windwalker, Death Knight, dealing tons of damage. Wealthy Man falling behind, trying to get space, but unable to escape. Garecki leaps into the fight, adds a stun, immediately escapes to safety. Doesn't want to get clotheslined by Snuts again and possibly go down and throw the game for his team. Snuts backs Wealthy Man up, life gripping him back. Smexen, though, able to reconnect. Garecki sneaks in again, adding just a tiny bit of extra damage. Garecki has definitely changed his playstyle. He's not spending too much time in there, but he's adding just a little bit of damage that may be enough for his team to get this ice block here as they try to push for it. Cubsy not responding. Very interesting decision by Cubsy to not use Iron Bark here. Now using it potentially too late. It could be an overlap. They can't stay on target. Snuts is able to save the day.
That was huge greed from the Super Frogs, but it ultimately pays off. It's got to be frustrating for the boys having Wealthy Man so low and him just completely disrespecting the damage, ultimately holding on to that very crucial ice block in the matchup. Garecki once again sneaking away, looking for a drink. We'll have to see if he can get some mana here. It's going to be really important for the boys. Cubsy almost completely tapped here. So if the boys can get that as a mana lead, it's going to be really crucial for the matchup. Snuts getting low as he gets bursted down, potentially. Could be the dispersion. Garecki moves in for the crowd control on Cubsy. It's not over yet for Snuts. Could be his Void Shift moving forward. Smexen and Chun-Li still trying to reconnect on the Snuts. Cubsy does get out of the crowd control. Innervate active and easily catch up Snuts here, potentially. As Garecki moves in, they have the damage to potentially take Snuts down. Cubsy looking to deflect it with the Iron Bark, but I don't know if that's potentially going to be enough.
It may not be, as Chun-Li gets bursted. Touch of Karma forced to betrayed. Now he's a huge vulnerability moving forward into dampening. Mana is starting to even out. It's still anyone's match here in game number 5 in the upper bracket between the two tied top teams at 300 points apiece. This tournament will allow one of them to get ahead of the other. It's very important for seeding moving into the spring finals LAN later this year. We're already on cup number 4. There's only 2 more cups left. You definitely need to secure as many points as possible. Good denial by Wealthy Man there onto the Cyclone of Garecki, now opening an opportunity to kill Chun-Li, locking him down in center field with a bash. Wealthy Man gets peeled away by Smexen. Good defense on his part, stalling out a dangerous moment for his team.
Snuts a little bit in trouble there, but Cubsy does manage to keep him alive with that Iron Bark. Now Wealthy Man getting swapped to him. This is what we kind of talked about. The boys switching between Snuts and Wealthy Man, forcing Cubsy to heal multiple targets and gives him an opportunity to get this kind of burst damage down. Wealthy Man blinks away. He gets grip back in by Smex and into the Fist of Fury of Chun-Li. Wealthy Man has to hold on. We've seen greedy plays from him so far in this matchup, but it has paid off. Wealthy Man also almost has his Icy Veins available. That's going to be a huge offensive push for Super Frogs when they decide to pull the trigger with that.
Whoa!
Chun-Li getting bursted down. No touch of Karma. Fortifying Brew looking to deflect the kill for now. Has the Diffuse Magic if he really needs it. Mana quite even still at this point, Zid.
Yeah, it's anyone's match at 20% dampening, and that's 20% healing reduction. It just keeps getting higher and higher. Eventually, somebody will be going down, and it's, at this point, too close to call. Wealthy Man still has two Ice Blocks, potentially a lead for Super Frogs. Grecki is now basically tapped on mana. It's going to be do or die. Potentially, Grecki just needs to go and get into the fight, deal some damage, and try and close this fight. He's trying to drink right now. Does anyone see him? I don't think anyone sees Grecki. How much mana did he actually get is now the real question. He jumps in, lands a stun, got a significant amount of lead. Clutch drink by Grecki, keeping his team in the fight here, trying to reverse sweep the Super Frogs. Three in a row would be absolutely unbelievable. And if you're in the lower bracket, you're definitely terrified if either of these teams end up going down there. Now Cubsy's tapped, Grecki has a lead, Snuts is getting bursted, double stunlock combo by the boys, nets them a dispersion, as well as a bark skin. Cubsy prematurely expecting a swap, but they didn't actually commit it, so that's a bit of a throwaway on his bark skin. It may not result in too much, but we have to see if it plays out, if the boys look to punish that.
Yeah, Grecki once again looking for a re-stealth. He moves in, looking for crowd control, and Cubsy manages to find him in stealth with the stunlock. Now Snuts in trouble. He doesn't have a trinket. If he gets caught into his stun, he could go down without the void shift once again. He's getting lower. He gets interrupted. He might potentially go down if they have the burst. Gladiator Safeguard procs as well. Ironbark from Cubsy. But if you look, Cubsy, he has no mana left. How is he going to keep Snuts alive? Innervate, the last thing Cubsy really has available to get additional healing out onto Snuts. Chun-Li and Specs are both rotting down as well. Wealthy Man creating huge amounts of counter pressure for his team. Grecki has to respond with his own Ironbark. Fortifying Brew gets traded out by Chun-Li. They want to stay on target. Snuts getting lower. If they can get the Void Shift here, it's going to be huge for the boys.
They're pushing for it, but Chun-Li can't stay in the fight too much longer. He's falling behind. Grecki's mana is starting to tap out as well, with Dampening ramping up to critical mass. Smexen trying to get the kill by himself onto Snuts. Chun-Li rolls over, lands the interrupt, denies the Void Shift. One more second. Snuts barely gets it, and in the meantime, Chun-Li falls on the push. The boys fought it out valiantly, but in the end, the Super Frogs leap ahead.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up, 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.